Yeah.
Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Yeah, that works. If we go this way, it's all like four.
Gotta watch that tide. We got a lot of people. Just hit the bottom on quick.
How much?
Yeah, they're spending big money over there. Look at that shit. Those are the expensive fireworks. Look, that's Key Largo over there, the far side. Holy shit. That's Key Largo.
That is fucking gorgeous. You're gonna go closer?
I'll turn the lights on.
Yeah, better that way.
There we go. Is that better?
Far better. I'm zooming in as much as I can on the moon. God damn. I'm taking a video, which I can screenshot to a picture.
Okay, this looks like a good place as any. Or one of the Jurassic Park videos that I intend to film.
Yeah, right now I'm scouting for locations I could use for my videos. Right now I am finding quite a lot of spots. Oh, fuck. Whatever. I think this would be a good spot. Have a scene where the herbivores are drinking and out of the water comes Spinosaurus or a Dinosuchus. For those who don't know what a Dinosuchus is, that is a prehistoric crocodile, 40 feet long, weighs a couple of tons, an ambush predator, just like modern day crocodiles. It made an appearance in the Lost World Jurassic Park arcade game, and it was referenced in Jurassic World that Dinosuchus DNA was used to make the Indominus Rex's teeth. But I digress. That also looks like a good filming spot. More or less for a breakout scene, or have some tourists driving by and they see one of the dinosaurs being held in the exhibit. One thing I can guarantee you, I am not jumping over that barbed wire. I have been down that road before, and trust me, it's not fun. And over the river where those trees are, that looks like a good filming location. Now, behind those trees is a park that I used to go to do calisthenics. I'll just enter the park, make my way to the trees. Let's see where else we can go. This is what I used to do when I lived in Davie. To scout locations that seemed like they would be a good fit for my videos. So on the 4th of July, as you saw in the video, fuck, gnats in my eye. On the 4th of July, I did go snorkeling. First time doing it, by the way, and I have to say it was quite an experience for me. Granted, I was nervous because it's the ocean and shark attacks may be rare, but I was worried about being part of one of those rare occasions. I snorkeled from the boat all the way to the lighthouse. Everyone told me it was a far swim, but it didn't feel like a far swim to me. The only reason why it felt so prolonged is because I was minding my surroundings. I was looking left, looking right, looking behind me. Sometimes I would come up if my snorkeling gear got water in it. Shit, never mind. It's at the park. At the school. Eh, fuck it. I'll figure my way around those trees. When I was snorkeling, I came across what appeared to be barracudas. Though young barracudas. And they didn't seem very dangerous. They didn't seem like they wanted to attack me. After a couple of seconds, I got used to the barracudas and kept swimming to the lighthouse. And then I swam back. The way back was much faster. After getting back on the boat, some of the people got drunk. I did not. I have been 4 years sober, and I intend to keep it that way. But we ended up starting a barbecue. Then we got closer to the shore, hung out there for a little bit. And then we went to watch the fireworks Then me and my friend, who was captain of the boat, we dropped the other people off. And since I was riding with him home, I got to sit on the boat, chill out, and watch the blood moon, which was one of the most surreal sightings I have ever seen. And the whole way back to the car, which was about an hour and a half, I was just sitting there watching the moon. I barely went on my phone for a damn thing. We were on that boat from 8 in the morning all the way to 11:55 at night. It was a great experience, and I want to go snorkeling again. Oh, this time with a spear gun. I want to try spear fishing now. All right, so here's the park I was talking about earlier. Let's see if there's any locations worth using for my video. Yeah, where those trees are, that seems like a decent spot. Shit, this might come in handy as well. Yeah. Past that tennis court, that's where I used to do my bodyweight workouts. Sometimes I would bring a weighted vest just to add more resistance to those bodyweight workouts. I think I found plenty of locations. Now I'm heading home because it's about to start raining in a bit. So on top of the locations I just pointed out in this video, I'm also gonna be using my black table, decorating it with plastic trees, some fish tank props, just to give it that jungle type feel that Jurassic Park has in its movies. And mentioning my animation projects, I'm going to be working on Alien Black Harvest again. More or less set design, not filming anything just yet. I gotta get some cardboard for my job. Yeah, they let me take cardboard home. One of the perks of being one of their best workers. I need some cardboard to build a pawn shop, which is where my next scene for the Alien Black Harvest project is going to take place. Speaking about that scene in Alien Black Harvest, it's pretty fucking dark. It's probably the darkest I have ever gone with any of my videos, period. It's not so much violent as it is, it's psychological horror, really. For a good portion of this entire act, you're exploring the aftermath of the xenomorph. Like, the damage it leaves behind in its wake. And yes, the xenomorph will be in the background, just to remind the audience that, yeah, it's still a presence that could come from anywhere, at any given time. But a good chunk of that act involves the main character exploring just how fucked up things can get with just one xenomorph. Just one. Not a whole hive of them like the second movie and the fourth movie. It's very akin to Alien Isolation, the game, which I think is the best Alien game of all time. It's like the first half of that game stretched out, and the alien behaves more like it did in the original film, where it had a personality of its own in a way, as opposed to the hive mentality that James Cameron established in the second movie. That's not to knock the second movie. I still love that film. I just acknowledge that the alien was much less interesting in those films than it was in the original. That's what I got going on for animation. Am I filming anytime soon? Probably not this weekend. I'm waiting for something that I ordered off of eBay to help continue the filming I was doing for a Jurassic Park video that I filmed last week. And the week before. I ordered one of the vehicles that you see in the first Jurassic Park movie. It's one of the tour cars. Once I get that toy vehicle, I'll be right back on schedule.